Some skills can be learned overnight, but it always takes years of experience to master one. When we apply this to motorcycling, one can learn to operate the machine in a couple of days, but upgrading and upskilling needs experience. You must be wondering, why are we talking about all this? Because today we have a motorcycle that has been one of the most inspiring motorcycles for entrants in the performance category. Here we have the 2021 Honda CBR650R that replaced the popular CBR650F in 2019 for a Fireblade-like design and a host of other updates. So let's check out what the updated model has to offer, and is it still one of the best motorcycles to get into the space of performance motorcycling with? Let's start with design. We don't usually talk much or in detail about design, but this one deserves a special mention, because Honda has done a great job here with the CBR650R, ticking most of the boxes of how a sports bike should be. A muscular fuel tank, sporty graphics, aggressive dual headlamps, exposed quad exhaust pipes, and a sleek tail section. It's all there. And apart from being a highlight of the design part, these LED headlamps work great at night. Something that was a bit of an issue in the older CBR650F. Just below the headlamps are these neatly designed working air intakes. As is the case with all premium Honda motorcycles, the fit and finish of everything is top-notch. Special mention for the seats, as they are very comfortable, and the pillion seat is wide and genuinely usable, something that is rare with fully fared motorcycles. Moving to the ergonomics, like the CBR650F, the 650R is positioned in the sports tourer category, which means it should have a relaxed seating position with some sporty intentions. Well, the 650F had a very relaxed seating, almost upright with about 20 degrees of forward leaning, but the 650R is a bit different. Honda has moved the foot pegs slightly higher and also rearward, and the handlebar is also lower and a bit forward. As a result, you get a more aggressive riding position, which is somewhere between that of the 650F and a proper super sport motorcycle. Some might like it and some not so much, but it surely is going to be an advantage for people who'd like to take this out on track days. We found one flaw: the design of the knee recesses is not the best, and you may find the inner side of your knees fouling with the frame, and that surely is not the best experience. Another issue we felt is with the switchgear design, especially the placement of the horn and indicator switches. Both the switches are placed interchangeably with their conventional positions, which creates confusion initially, but that's something you'll get used to. The switchgear for traction control system is also placed at a rather odd position where you would usually have a headlight flash switch. But you do need to keep it pressed for a second or so to engage or disengage the traction control system, so at least you will not be toggling the system by mistake. The four-cylinder engine has always been the highlight of the CBR650, and it builds on the trend strongly. While the 650F felt muted, the new CBR 650R has a very nice and decent four-cylinder exhaust note. It is still not the loudest one, but the distinct quality of its sound surely makes it a head-turner. The construction of the liquid-cooled inline 4 motor remains almost unchanged, but the big change is with the character. The peak power now comes about 1000 RPM later, so you get a higher red line to play with. The engine is amazingly refined and pretty docile as well, below 6000 RPM. You can easily ride the motorcycle in fourth gear at as low as 25 km per hour, and that makes it city friendly. Heat management is also quite decent, and it is only on some scorching days that you can feel the heat from the engine on your legs. But if you want to experience the true potential of the CBR 650R, just cross the 6500 RPM mark. It's then that it takes on an entirely different character. It feels like a mode change, like a boost button, but you get all that power being delivered in a linear way. And that kind of power management is exactly what makes it a great motorcycle for beginners in the middleweight segment. The gear shifts are slick thanks to the slipper and assist type clutch, and the clutch lever is also very light to pull. There is not much electronic gadgetry apart from the dual channel ABS and switchable traction control. You don't get any riding modes or further assistance, and you don't really feel the need as well. But one thing that feels a bit outdated is the reverse LCD instrument cluster. It is of good size and shape and also provides all the necessary information in a very simple layout. But in this day and age, when most of the rival brands are offering color TFT dash with smartphone connectivity and even over-the-air updates, this unit looks tired and dated. The front suspension of the CBR 650R is Showa's separate function big piston fork, which works great on well-conditioned roads. Even the rear monoshock is in sync with the front unit, and the combination offers you a smooth ride on regular city and highway tarmac and a nice balance on racetracks. On bad roads, however, the setup feels a bit on the firmer side. The brakes are phenomenal, especially in terms of feedback that you get from the road to the lever. It has a setup from Nissan with twin front and single rear disc brakes, and they provide a good anchor on the motorcycle. Keeping some very minor issues aside, the CBR 650R continues to be one of the most likable and manageable motorcycles for riders who are planning to get their first big bike. People who don't like very committed riding positions could have a problem with the new version, but those who like to lean in the corners will definitely find it better. And when it comes to the pricing, it is not among the most affordable ones like its predecessor, but at 8.9 lakh Indian rupees ex-showroom price tag, it is in line with the competition.